And we're back. So if I'm not mistaken, I leveled up enough to get my bow. Use that, which is going to be handy. I'll equip my arrows. But unfortunately, I think that puts me into the fat roll territory, which it does. So I'm, for now, since I can't do anything about that, I'm going to have to drop... drop some weight. So there we go. We're gonna make our way up and fight the first like real boss of the game here in a second. I'm gonna actually try to make him kill himself. Oh, wow, this is a bad start. There we go. That extra strength is helping quite a bit. I'm also gonna try to kindle the bonfire. And we forgot to pick up the item behind the Black Knight, so I'll do that while I'm over here as well. Hitting me with fire bombs. What's that guy? I'm just gonna ignore him. I think that item up there is more fire bombs. My character looks like a drowner from The Witcher. I've been playing that game a lot lately, and it's really good. See, there are those invincibility frames. You can just whack away all day and not hit anything. There's a lot of slowdown on this game. So, this item down here I forgot to grab when we killed the Black Knight because I was so scared about my health. But it's really nothing all that great. I believe it's just a Tearstone ring, which I have no use for later. I'll equip it right now, because it boosts my defense when my HP is low, and I might as well since I don't have any other rings, but that will be ditched very shortly once I pick up a couple more rings. I have one in particular right around the corner here that I'm looking forward to getting. Now this trap sucks. Actually, I used to have my setup wrong. Now that I have this, I can avoid that trap, potentially. Whoops. So that guy's gonna kick that barrel, and it's gonna roll down and try to blow you up. But I might be able to... Whoop. That was a bad shot. Yeah, there we go. Just avoid the whole thing altogether. That has killed me before in the past, a few different times. Because you're just running along, you forget that it's there. And it whacks the crap out of you. Yep, another part where the master key is useful. All crawling through these barrels is so much fun. You know what? I'm not gonna go out there yet. Not yet. I'm gonna try something real quick. I want to go down here and meet our good old buddy, the baddest of the bad. This guy smashed the crap out of me so many times the first time I played this game. But I'm going to win. Oh no, I'm not! Oh crap, that was rough. That was a yeah. I'm gonna have to go back down there to get my souls. Now normally I just I'm a couple levels higher than this normally, but I do come down here and fight Havel real early because he's not bad if you get your parry timing down. But I don't think I'm gonna do that today. I'm gonna give it one more try, and then I'm gonna give up and move onward. There we go, that's what I want. See how much damage that does. Nope, not enough. Screw it, I'm leaving. I'd have to do that a whole bunch of times. Hopefully he doesn't follow me too far. Still following me. Well, looks like I'm gonna have to do what I'm gonna have to do. He's pretty easy to parry because his swings take so long. It's just I'm gonna have to do it a bunch of times to kill him. Whew, that was a close one. As you can see, I have a fair amount of practice fighting him. He's probably gonna kill me here. I'm getting pretty lucky. All it takes is one mix-up and I'm toast. But his ring is, like, god tier. That's one of the best items in the game, in my opinion. He doesn't even want any look at him. He's like, just do it. Just kill me. I don't like it anymore. Oh, what the? He tricked me. If you could see the look on my face right now, you would understand. Oh, it's gonna be a party in here. Those guys in the background can't get in. Look at them. fucked up. I wonder if I can get on the stairs. Oh man, that opened the floodgates. There is a boss up here at the top of the stairs that we're about to fight, and I'm gonna try to get him to kill himself. I've done it a couple of times in the past. It can be a bit tricky, but see what we can do. I'd like to be able to do it. It's kind of fun. You always gotta come up here first, otherwise these guys will be peppering you for the whole fight. I'm not gonna have crap for Estus for this battle. Okay. Now things are getting a little ridiculous. Well, I might get slayed here. We'll see. Especially if I'm trying to get him to kill himself. Normally you can go this whole battle with never getting hit, but I'll show you the way that is designed. What he does is you drop down and you say, oh shit, and you run away real quick here. When you climb up this ladder, and then you fall, slam him in the face, and it takes like a huge chunk of his health off. But what you want to do, if you want to get him to kill himself, is come over here and you stay under him like this, and sometimes he flies off the edge. Okay, well, I don't know how well this is gonna go. Pull out of here real quick. If you keep your shield up and block his attacks, there really isn't too much you can do. I mean, it drains your stamina, but he's so slow that come on, buddy, you can do it. Jump off the cliff. Yeah. Oh, that's what I get, I guess. That's what I get. Well, looks like I'll just fight him the normal way. He almost went off. Okay, take two. We're gonna do this time. I may or may not have gotten killed on the way back and lost all my souls. You'll never know, because I cut it. Yep. No, it's just boring running back, so I figured I'd just cut that out, and then on the way I got killed, which goes to show just how when you're not being careful you can get screwed over. This time I was a little more careful coming back, and I saved all my Estus. So this fight should be a little easier. Also, I'm probably just gonna fight him. I might try to get him to jump off the edge, but I don't know. Oh, good. Alright, this time I'm just gonna fight him normal. The cheap way, falling on his head. Actually, I might not do that, I don't know. But I'm just gonna fight him normal. I'm not gonna get him to fly off the edge. And I'm gonna try to stop myself from flying off the edge as well. This fight is not going well. I got out of my way. I'm just gonna do the cheap way, I don't even care. Whatever. Now if you stay up here too long, he jumps up here with you. So what you do is you do that, and then you run away. A little scared little child, and then when he attacks, just run back by him the other direction and rinse and repeat. It only takes a couple. Oh, he's gonna get me. Oh, that was close. I have no Estus flasks left because I got destroyed on my way here. I just staggered him, whacking his wiener. Well, so that's the Taurus Demon. I only died 5 times trying to get him. Actually, it was 4, but still. He's really not. Or not Taurus. He's not hard. Anyways, I made that a lot harder than it had to be. Right here is where the level design starts to open up and show you how intricate this world is designed and how cool it is. Because this is actually... Let's see if I can show you without getting shot. Down. Oh! Yep, I... definitely triggered that. So down there below us is where we were before, is what basically all I was trying to show you. And that guy is the one that flew over in the beginning, and he just almost killed me. Let's see how pissed off we can get him. Oh, he doesn't even care. I want to hit him right in the face, see what happens. Nothing, he doesn't care. Probably did, like, no damage to him. Alright, and down here is our sun bro, Solair. This guy's the coolest. Wave to him. Hello. Hello, Solair. Actually, I wonder what's in his helmet. Let's see if we can see what's inside of him. I don't think I've ever been this close to Solaire's face before. Kinda like it. Okay, so little known fact, Solair doesn't have hair. He's bald. He has blue eyes. Can't see if he has any facial hair. Oh well. So, Solaire's a baldy.
Ah, hello. You don't look hollow. I am Solaire of Astora, an adherent of the Lord of Sunlight. Now that I am undead, I have come to this great... You find that strange? No need to hide your reaction. I get that look all the...
Hey, I'm not done with you.
Oh, aha. I have a proposition, if you have a moment.
I do. I do have a moment.
The way I see it, our fates appear to be intertwined. In a land brimming with hollows, could that really be mere chance? So what do you say? Why not help one another on this lonely journey?
Yeah, I'll help you out, dude.
Please be grateful. Well then, take this. We are amidst strange beings in a strange land. The flow of time itself is convoluted, with heroes centuries old phasing in and out. The very fabric wavers, and relations shift and obscure. There's no telling how much longer your world and mine will remain in contact. But you think to summon one another as spirits, cross the gaps between the worlds, and engage in jolly cooperation.
Jolly cooperation!
Engaged in this. But I am a warrior of the sun. Spot my summon signature easily by its brilliant aura. If you miss it, you must be blind.
So, basically, he just explained PvP to us real quick. Or not PvP, but co-op. You find signs and put signs down, and people summon you into their world, and you summon people into yours, but you need to be... You can't be hollow like I am right now. So, I'm gonna kindle a bonfire here shortly, and it'll get us more Estus flasks in between, or at the checkpoints. This might be rough. I don't want to die, because this is a long run. So I don't know how I'm going to handle this. I just grit my teeth and go. Oof. I made it. Alright, in this area, you can go down here and go forward, which I never do. But I use a different path. But if you come down here, you can kick this ladder out, and it drops down, and then this bonfire right here is the same one we were at before. But now you can climb up the ladder and proceed forward because we have the whole level ahead of us there. So, I'm gonna level up. I forget what I'm trying to do. I think I'm going for 20 strength and 18 dex. Yep, 20 and 18. And this requires 24 and 10. Alright. So we can get that fairly quick. Then we're gonna go up and go, keep going the same way. We're gonna have to mess with that dragon in the way I'm fighting it right now. Actually show you a trick as well. An easy way to get a good, very good item early in the game, which I never use and I don't plan on it this time, but my first playthrough it helped me out immensely. So you come up here and over this way, and there's gonna be a dude, and he's like, "Oh, sword!" And you're like, "Back." And then there's gonna be still alive. And there's gonna be a couple of rats over here, which are in that thing. Watch out for them. All right. So you have a bow and arrow, like I do. You can sit down here. Okay, there we go. See down there, that's where that sniper is, and then up those stairs is where that trap was, and then up there's the Taurus demon. The level design in this game is phenomenal. Alright, so that big dragon's up there, as you can see. But if you have a bow, you just sit here and try not to miss like that. Oh, he's pissed. He's really pissed. He usually doesn't come down like that. Usually he can just sit there and shoot his tail all day. So you just sit here and hold and shoot. And I'll cut back, but basically, holy, I need to get my timing down. If you just keep shooting his tail, eventually you'll get an item. A really good one. For early game, that is. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'll cut back right before I get it. Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. So, you get the Drake Sword, and let me get away from the cliff so I don't jump off by accident. The Drake Sword is a really good weapon for this point in the game. Like you can see, it does 200 physical damage, where my Battle Axe only does 95. So, I'll probably use it for the time being. Just because it's easier. And you can go that way. There's a couple rats and things, but I don't like going that way. I prefer to go this way. So what I do is I come up here, run over, get him to torch everyone. Frame rate drops to about 4. And you hang out here for a couple seconds. He'll come down eventually here. I wonder what I got his health down to. I was sitting there for a while shooting him with arrows. Of course, I bought the weak ones, so... Come on. Come on, buddy. Alright, so he lands and you run. And don't stop. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, I have fat roll again. Oh, that's crap. That's bullcrap. Okay, well, this isn't the thing that happens. Okay, this guy, he is not liking it very much right now. Alright, so let's see. I'm gonna have to check out my equip load. It has to be under 25%? So, let's see, what this way is 6, and that way is 4. I'm not going to drop any more armor, so I'll just go back to the battle axe. It's fine. I'll kill these guys and get some free souls, but I feel really bad about it. Because they're... Like, that guy was just sitting there crying with his head in his hands. It makes you almost feel remorse for these guys. Like, look at this one. Whoa. I've never seen their eyes like that. That's kind of nuts. Hey. I wonder if he'll try to kill me if I aggro him. Oh, yeah. You don't have to, buddy. I'm gonna leave you alone. If you don't want any, I'll leave you alone. Yay, I made it. Bonfire.